Let's now study the characteristics of beta decay. For beta decay, we can write beta emission takes place to make the composition of a nucleus more stable in respect of balancing internal forces. We already studied inside the nucleus. A nucleus is stable because of nuclear forces and electric repulsive forces between protons. So, if the forces are not balanced, the composition becomes less stable or unstable. And to make the composition of nucleus more stable, beta emission takes place. We'll discuss here in detail. We can also write that there are three fundamental ways in which beta emission take place. Either of these are possible in various situations. These are, the very first is one by one I'll be taking, that is beta minus emission, which is also written as beta minus. Basically, this emission is executed whenever inside the nucleus number of protons are relatively less compared to number of neutrons. So, for this we can write, in this process, beta minus particles, which are basically electrons with the mass number 0 and charge minus 1, which are termed as beta minus particles, are emitted from nucleus 1 inside a neutron decays to a proton according to reaction. The base reaction can be written as when are inside a nucleus and neutron decays to a proton, a beta minus particle, which is an electron, is emitted to conserve mass as well as charge. And some energy is released, which is taken away by this beta particle, and it is released. Later, we'll study that to conserve the fundamental laws, some more particles are emitted. But initially, we can understand how the beta minus particle or an electron is emitted from nucleus. Inside, when a neutron transforms into a proton, the composition becomes more stable, because earlier the nuclear forces were too high to make it unstable. A neutron, when decays to a proton, the system can get stabilized. At nuclear level, we can write, if the parent nucleus was X, which is having atomic number Z, mass number A, it decays to the daughter nucleus Y, where one proton is increased, so its charge number is increased by 1, but no effect on its mass. And an electron or a beta minus particle is emitted. This is the way how a beta minus reaction is written, and how this radioactive radiation of beta minus particle is emitted from the nucleus. Let's continue on the next sheet about other ways of beta emission. Let's continue with the second type of beta emission, that is written as beta plus emission. Beta plus emission, we can say here, beta plus particles are emitted from nucleus 1 inside a proton, inside nucleus, a proton transforms into a neutron. according to the reaction, we can also write the reaction like we have written for beta minus emission here. A proton, 1p1, transforms to a neutron plus a beta plus particle, which is actually a positron, which is written as beta plus. You can understand here one thing which is very important, that the mass of a free neutron is more than mass of a free proton. So this reaction is practically not possible in nature. But inside the nucleus, we know that the nuclear mass is less than overall masses of protons and neutrons. So inside the nucleus, when protons are excess and the electric force is not being balanced by the nuclear forces, so the composition is made more stable by this kind of emission, which a proton transforms into a neutron. And we can also write that this reaction can only occur inside a nucleus, not in free space, like whereas in case of beta minus emission, the decay of neutron to a proton is also possible in free nature, but this is not possible outside the nucleus. Only this happens inside the nucleus when electric forces are marginally higher than the nuclear forces. So a proton decays to a neutron, and the composition, in the new composition after decay, the forces get balanced. At nuclear level, the reaction can be written as X. If there is a parent nucleus X, which is having Z and A as charge and mass number, it decays to the daughter nucleus Y. And here, as one charge is emitted as beta plus emission, so it will have charge number reduced by 1, and the beta plus particle, which is a positron, is emitted. Here also some more particles are emitted, which we'll see later to conserve the fundamental laws. But here to understand, you can see how the positron or a beta plus particle is emitted from nucleus. And the third kind of beta emission is termed as K capture. This is a phenomena in which here we can write this kind of beta decay is similar to beta plus emission, which we have just now studied here. But what happens exactly in K capture is beta plus emission in the nucleus pulls the orbital electron, which is nearest to the nucleus, and capture it from K shell, which is the innermost shell and the close proximity of nucleus. And it's one proton combined with this electron and transform to a neutron. According to reaction, this reaction will better explain you the phenomena. Inside the nucleus, if we have a proton, it captures one electron from the K shell, which is very close to the nucleus. In case of heavy element, this phenomena occurs. So this combines with the electron, for which we can write it as a K shell electron, and it transforms into a neutron, which is 0 and 1. You can see in beta plus emission also, a proton was getting transformed into a neutron and was emitting a beta plus particle. But here you can see an electron is captured from K shell and a proton transformed to neutron, but no physical particle is emitted from the nucleus. And in nuclear form, you can see if there is a parent nucleus X, which is having charge and mass number Z and A, if it captures its internal K shell electron, then it transforms to the daughter nucleus Y, where it is having nuclear charge Z minus 1 and mass A. But you can see physically there is no particle emitted from the nucleus. But as the reaction is similar to the reaction in beta plus emission, the daughter nuclei have a similar configuration of nuclei, That's why this K capture is written as it is similar to beta plus emission, which we have recently discussed. So, in different situations, either of the two phenomena can take place, but the possibility of K capture is very less unless the K shell is very close to the nucleus, so that before beta plus emission occurs, if K shell electron is captured, then this phenomena will take place.